Hi, Dr. Ron Englund. I'm going to do something today that you'd probably have done quite a few times. I'm going to deal from a deck of cards, only I'm going to do it computer terms. Now, dealing a deck of cards using, I'm going to do this with JavaScript and HTML, is typically you wouldn't think of it as being a very challenging thing to do, but actually it does have some real challenges associated with it. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm not going to create a full deck of 52 cards. I'm just simply going to create a deck with 5 cards. Right here, you can see I've actually created an array called cards in deck with a variable number of cards in deck, which is 5, and the array goes from 0 to 4. So there's 5 cards there, and they're going to be the ace of hearts, clubs 2, clubs ace, diamonds king, spades jack. I just picked 5 cards kind of at random from a deck of cards, created image files of those cards, and placed those image files on a server, right, where you can have access to them. So those images of those cards are actually sitting there on the server. Now, if we run this, now I'm going to do a run. If I deal the card, you're going to see a card, a card, a card, a card, a card. So it dealt 5 cards, and if I keep dealing, it's not going to do anything. I actually put a check in there, and it will always deal. See, if I run it again, it will deal them randomly, but it will never deal the same card twice, which is one of the things you've got to learn to do when you're doing something like this, like dealing a deck of cards out. So let's look and see how this is actually happening. Now I am using jQuery here, and I've actually only got one thing in my HTML. I have an input button with the ID deal. That's it. That's the only HTML I've written. I'm working in JS Fiddle. Okay, I'm using jQuery. Now I'm using jQuery 2.0.2, but it really doesn't matter what version of jQuery you're using right here because I'm not using any jQuery 2.0 specific functions. It's basic jQuery. Allows me to access things fairly easily. So since I've got this input button here, I've got this ability to capture the click of the jQuery and tell it to run this function deal card, passing it a random card. That's it. Okay, so the function deal card is called when you click deal, passed a value from random card. We'll need to look to see what those things do. So let's first look at random card. Now my array runs from 0 to the number of cards in the deck, and the function that returns a random integer between 0 and the number of cards in the deck would be math.floor, math being a built-in JavaScript class, with math.random and in this case, you can see the time symbol, number of cards in the deck. I wish I could move this over a little bit so you could actually, we can do that. So you can actually see it in one line. There you go. Math.floor, okay, which is a function, math function, math time, math.random times number of cards in deck. Well, this will return a number between 0 and the number of the cards in the deck, and the floor actually makes it the lowest. If it's like 1.2, it'll return 1. If it's 2.5 or 2.7, it'll return 2. That's what those functions do. So I know that I'm getting a random number, and I pass that over to deal card. Well, what does deal card do? Well, let's look at deal card. Remember I said that when you actually click on that deal card more than the number of cards, okay, it stops. So that's just because at the very beginning I checked to see if the number of the cards in the deck is 0. And every time you deal it, I am going to decrement that number. So here's what I do. I create an image using document create element, and it's an image. Okay, I set the source equal to. Now, this is the first part of the string, which is really the server that I have this stuff on. Then cards in deck, which is the array, element I. Remember, that's a string. So if the name of the file, okay, in this case, let's say it's acehearts.png. This will go to the server and get acehearts.png. So basically, it's just going to a location on a server and pulling up a URL for the source of that image. And all I simply do is name all the cards in my deck by these names and stick it in this array. I started with 5 cards. I could have easily started with 52 cards. Wouldn't have been any big deal. Then, because I've created that image, I need to put it in the body. So I just do document.body, append child, and I pass it the image that I created right here. So I created this image. Then the last little piece of thing that I do here is remove card. Well, what is remove card is simply removing the card from the deck of cards because I've dealt it. Now, remove card is not any magical trick or magical feat. All I do is I take the card that was just dealt. Let's say it's card number 3. Okay, I replace the array element 3 with array element 4. 3 no longer exists if I replace the element with 3. So in other words, if I deal the 2 of clubs, and that's element 1, well, if I replace cards in deck 1 with cards in deck 2, element 1 now becomes clubs ace, clubs 2 disappears entirely, and then all I have to do to finish it off is decrement the number of the cards in the deck by 1. Now there is one little trick here that you got to look at. You do this in a for loop where I start with the card that was just dealt, but I go to number of cards in the deck minus 2. And the reason is because I replace the cards in the deck of the element by the cards in the deck of the element plus 1, the next element up. Remembering that the number of the cards, the array, is already 1 less than the number of cards in the deck. It goes from 0 to number of cards in deck minus 1 because it's a 0 indexed array. So I have to do minus, it has to go from the card to minus 2. And then that will simply work. I can run it one more time. Deal my cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No more cards will deal, and I'm not going to get a duplication of any card that was in there. It really is that simple. All the source code that you might need for this is on my JS Fiddle site. You should have no trouble making decks of cards and dealing away. Thank you very much, and good programming.